Good evening, everyone. It's Colette, your host here for Out Late But Great on Tuesdays. This week's topic is Open Topic Week, and I've actually chosen to talk about something that I've been avoiding about talking about in my personal life and public life, and that's the upcoming presidential inauguration. I'm not specifically talking about that or the election, but it's basically part of it. And that is, as the LGBT community, I've felt it from a lot of people and heard it from a lot of people that they're really freaked out and just feeling really uneasy and uncertain, as I'm sure a majority of people are, not just the LGBT community. And so these are just some suggestions that I have that maybe might make you feel more empowered, make you feel a little bit more easy in your mind. And by no means do I think these are a cure-all or whatever, but if you have any other suggestions or recommendations, please list them below, because I'm sure viewers would appreciate it. But first things, I believe Out Late But Great will be very essential in the next 4 years, because for me, Out Late But Great has always been such a safe place, a place to find connection and to kind of, I don't know, just did not feel so alone and isolated, especially when I was at the very beginning of my transition. I always loved coming to Out Late But Great. Like, I would watch all the hosts' videos, and even if I didn't comment, I would just, I don't know, it gave me some sort of sense of peace. So I really recommend checking in on our channel here every week. And if you have topics or stuff that you're concerned about, definitely let us know what they are, because I'm sure we'd love to address them any way that we can. You know, it keeps the dialogue going and the connection going. So that's my first suggestion. My second suggestion is to stay off Facebook and social media. Now, that's very difficult to do because we're all social creatures and we want to belong to what's going on. But what I mean by staying away from Facebook is, if you see a lot of people posting a lot of political rants, sharing stuff that just kind of gets you edgy or makes you feel anxious or enraged or something, you know, you can hide those people. You can hide their posts. You don't actually unfriend them, but you can unfollow them. So then you don't get that in your feed. I personally just have basically been staying off of Facebook. The only time I check in on it is if someone has sent me a message, or it's someone's birthday, or if there's someone I'm thinking about and I just want to see how they're doing, I skip my feed and I go directly to that. I even took the app off my phone, everything, because there's just so much negativity on that website or something that I just can't. For me, it's like a trigger, so I just stay away from it. The other thing that I would recommend avoiding, if you can, is the news. I'm not talking all the news. I mean, there's your local news, there's NPR. NPR is actually probably the place that I would get most of my news, because it seems rampant that there's so much fake news, there's so much sensationalism, and it's really hard to sift through what is actually real, what's resourced, what is legit information. And that's the part about Facebook that I hate, is like, so many people post all these blog posts written by who knows who. And that's the thing about the internet. Like, you don't really know where the sources are coming from. Like, I can write a manifesto on in a blog and, you know, try to make it sound the most like I know everything, and people will like share that, and it's like, I don't know anything, you know? So you have to be really skeptical about what you read and what you see, especially in the news, because a lot of that is basically fear-based sensationalism. Same with posts online. It's just clickbait to get you click on it. And that's the thing you have to be really wary of, because I really feel that the media has really made us feel scared of everything. And that's why I feel like people have this uncertainty and anxiety as well, because we're feeding into it. We're feeding into the machine. Because I remember back when I was living alone in Los Angeles, and I didn't have TV, I didn't have internet, and I was just working a lot and just being out and about with people all the time. And I was never scared. I never had like these like, you know, impending thoughts or whatever. Like, yeah, there were some scary instances, but it was never like part of my daily consciousness constantly. And I never was scared of the person next to me. I just wasn't, you know, I based everything on my gut reaction as opposed to these outside forces. And I feel like that's what we kind of need to get in touch with, is our gut reaction to things. Because your gut, when you get rid of all that noise, is literally not going to lead you the wrong way most of the time, in my experience. But so I kind of feel like avoiding those two areas might help. Another good thing that you can do is find a way to contribute. For me, it's posting again on my YouTube channel. That's something I took a sabbatical from, and now I'm back to posting on there because I feel, I've heard this from a lot of trans women and men, that they're scared to be visible now. And I'm like, don't be scared about it, because I understand why, but at the same time, for me, it's like, okay, people need to see that people are thriving. And that is another thing. The best form of activism, in my opinion, is being who you are, living your truth and being authentic. That is activism in action. You know, you can protest, you can do this, but when you live your life and you're saying, this is who I am and I'm going to live it unapologetically, that is a form of activism as well. So don't let anyone make you feel like that's not, because to me, when I see, when I don't know that someone is trans or gay or whatever, but they're living their life, they've got their partner, they've got whatever, and this is what they want, to me, that's so empowering that you're changing hearts and minds every day and you don't even realize it. I mean, there's a lot of positive stuff that happens. Even if the media and everything else says that it's all getting bad, you know in your sphere what's bad and what's not bad. So usually if you kind of keep it more self-awareness and around your home, I kind of feel like that might put you at ease. Another thing you can do is get involved with your local government, because usually what affects your day-to-day life is your local government. So you can join a board, you can help campaign an election official that you might like. Another big thing that you can do is write letters to people you feel like can affect change. That could be Cory Booker, it could be Elizabeth Warren, there could be some up-and-comers. And, you know, let them know why you feel like the election went the way they did, what we should focus on, stuff like that. I mean, some other local chapters could be Stonewall Democrats if you lean that way. I think there's the Log Cabin Republicans that are, I think that's like gay Republicans. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that. But there's a lot of local chapters that you can kind of see if you really feel like you want to get involved. I know that on the 21st of January, a lot of cities are having women's marches to go along with the Washington, D.C. march. So you can get together with friends this week and make protest signs and go march around your state capitol or wherever you're having the event to kind of feel that unity and that connection with people. It's something I'm toying with going. I have an appointment that morning, so maybe afterwards I might jump in, but we'll see. We'll see how I feel about it, because I'm not really, I don't know how comfortable I feel protesting, but at the same time, it would be kind of cool to just feel connections with people. So those are some suggestions that I have that might make you feel more at ease. One last thing that I will say is to focus on yourself and what makes you happy and what would make you feel as a better person. Because self-improvement is another way that you can help affect change. Because if you're living a happy life, you kind of spread that around. And that sort of energy you release, you attract that back. So I kind of feel like if a lot of people were on a happy path, that might help shift things. So, you know, that's some suggestions I have. I mean, there's even, you can get involved with your local prayer group if you're, you know, more spiritually conscious, because I am a firm believer if you're praying together in a group or meditating at a high frequency, I really think you can affect change that way as well. So those are just some suggestions I have. I'm curious to see what, you know, everyone else has to come up with, and hopefully this video leaves you feeling a little bit more, less freaked out. I mean, for me, I kind of went through this massive grieving process, and now I'm to the point where it's like, no, I can do some things in my own way that can help, and I'm going to be kind to everyone. I'm going to keep radiating that, because I don't want to give in to that, and I don't want to feed into that sort of machine. You know, I want to be aware. I don't want to be ignorant, but I do not want to be infected, if that makes sense. So that's my take on this week's open topic. I hope you guys have a great rest of your week. Gremlin says hello, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.